How's it going, everybody? This is Kinema, and we are back with some Terraria. So I built this place on the last time. It looked pretty much like this. I wanted to do something a little different today. Each time you load up a world, you have a couple of different bosses. So you have the, the I can't think of the Destroyer or the Crimson, or Crimson is what I'm going into. You have this over here. You have the Corruption, and so you have this Corruption. You have the Eater of Worlds. That's what I was trying to think of. It's down in that. And another one of those shackle things. Let me start seeing if I can sell those. This has been actually several weeks since my last episode you probably watched. Even though it's been only a few days probably for you. And part of the reason, said it on the vlogs, so if you've stuck around with my channel, check some of those out. Had a lot of personal stuff going on. But yeah, so I'm gonna leave this world. Save and exit. And the nice thing with Terraria versus Minecraft is you can go into different worlds. You can select your character and then select your world. Now, I've already checked out some of these because I was looking for some other items. Let's see, I guess it's kind of the same time frame. Was actually trying to look for like pyramids in the deserts. I'm just gonna spam this since I don't run out, mainly just for some lighting for you, for y'all. You got the desert. Now I know sometimes it can spawn right under the sand, and other times you can actually see a pyramid, but we don't have that. What we do have is coming up here very shortly. Should be the Crimson area. Now there's When you spawn a world, you get two areas. You get this, the Crimson area, which has kind of looking the same looking things. They give you some vertebrae. They have a lot of torches. Okay, I'll start using those. So mainly for people to see. So, and there's some things I can break. Okay, I hadn't gone all the way down. I got this chest, right? Yeah. Got some spiders. And I don't know if I'm actually too low yet. Nope, I don't know why I still have this on. Not sure if I'm too low. I've only done this boss like as I was before, as I was extremely overpowered for them. But considering you get like lesser potions, and this seems to be taking out these blood crawlers fairly easy, figured I would give it a shot. Now you may notice some things that kind of look like the demon altars in the corruption. You have them here too, and this just keeps going down. Okay. Oh, am I gonna need bombs? No, this pickaxe should. Where's my. Okay. Turn that back on. I like that control feature where it just automatically mines out. So this crimson block, I wonder if you can make that into bricks. Have to check that out. And I don't remember. Chill goes down my spine. Oh no. And you know what? Ooh, there's a chest and a heart down there. That's pretty cool. Actually, let me get that. Does that clear out? Excuse me. Bombs. That will make this easier. Loot all. And actually. Let's drop a couple of these bombs. It's not going the way that I want, so let's get back in here. So you can see, can break three of these. And here we go. This brain thing is opened. Lots of hearts. I need them. Can't see his life, but I'm taking out a lot of those. Oh, wow. Lots. Oh, maybe I had to kill those other things before actually hurting him. He's being a little bit of a pain. Teleporting around, but not a problem. He's dying pretty quick with this gun. And there we go. So, we've got some more ore. Looks like regular stuff. Let's actually. What am I sitting at? Not bad at all. Let's fight him a second time, just because I probably won't make it back to this world. I have to see what we can make with that Crimsonite stuff. So you get different rods. Oh, that's a horrible gun. Let's find some of these others. And we got that other one. Maybe we can use some bombs down there. But there's that actually an ocean chest and a statue right there. Ooh, maybe I'll use that. Let's get this chest. Looks like there may be some stuff. Loot it all. Can I go back up this way? Yeah, I can. Now you may notice I am actually full. I don't technically need any of more of those hearts. But it doesn't hurt to have them. They actually make something very cool. There's a lantern you can use, and you need those hearts for it. That may break it. And here comes his little eye things. Get out of the way. Oh, that took a bunch out. I know, I kind of sat right on top of him, but with all the hearts coming down, it's pretty easy. Definitely not powerful. I know I'm not anywhere near powerful enough for hard mode, but definitely think I'm a little overpowered to be doing this, so that's good at least. Anything else of use down here? Not really. So, depending on which world you go into, I would recommend definitely checking out some of the other worlds. If you get the Crimson, you know, go in and check out what's down here? Another heart. This should break that. Okay, let's get out of here. Single player, me, and go into my... Oh, did I click my world? Yes, I did. So we have quite a bit of stuff. We... Two of these panic, increased movement speed after being stuck. Have this ore, so if we check out what that's supposed to be, we have a couple of these magic wands. Fork, it's not bad. This one actually has a bonus on it. I hope we can re-roll that from talking to Raz up here or whatever. Graphene. Let's see, what does this ore give us? Bars. Okay, what about tissue sample? Okay, so we can make, let's see, that pickaxe is only 70. So basically, it kind of has similar stuff. To what you can make with the the corruption stuff. After that, we checked out these blocks. Make flesh blocks. Okay. Vertebrae, anything. Battle potions. Increase, that's not bad. Bloody spine. Okay. So 15 of those, we can use to summon them. And the mechanical, okay. So that's good. This is on our hard mode. So we'll hang on to that stuff. We got 7, we may have to go back and get some more. But so quite a bit done. Definitely go check out any world depending on what you get. And do kind of like what I've been doing. I mean, you see, I've done quite a bit of expansion in here between going down. I'm not quite into the hell area yet. Still need to do that. Been exploring multiple areas, multiple corruption, and do that in multiple worlds. Go in, look, you know, you look for these trees to get those, the living wood stuff. Oh yeah, I think I got, what am I doing with them? Maybe I didn't get it. Yeah, I did get it. I should put it down here. If you to make those big trees, you have to have these two wands. Places leaves, places living wood. So I did get those basically by finding another tree area. Where is it? Kind of like this. There was a chest in this area. So look for those. Just look for different areas. But then I would definitely pick one world you go into hard mode with, like this one, and carefully explore it. Do things that you need to do beforehand. I am pretty concerned with the fact that this is only the jungle area. I know you have quite a bit of stuff to do in the jungle in hard mode, but yeah. So far everything is doing very well. Slowly getting caught up. I should be ready for hard mode soon. That way then I can start making some of the stronger armor and get some of the cooler things. But I'd like to do a little bit more exploring before then. And I know the 3 point or the 1.3 update should be coming extremely soon. So hope you enjoyed this video of the Crimson. And for more Terraria videos, just check out my my channel, previous Let's Plays. And when it comes time to go, I may do more videos on events and different things with 1.3. So this has been Kinema, and I'll talk to you later.